Hi, I'm Allan Williams and I'm Professor of Tourism and Mobility Studies at the University of Surrey. In the UK, there have been recurrent concerns that productivity is much lower than in other major developed countries. And the tourism and hospitality sectors have especially low productivity. This really matters. Productivity influences not only how competitive you are, but also welfare and incomes. So against this background, my colleagues, Andrew Lockwood, Sangmon Park, Natina Yaduma and I obtained a research grant from the ESRC to study hotel productivity. Major reason for low productivity in hotels is that the demand for their services fluctuates so greatly and often unpredictably, seasonally, across a week, or even across the day. Hotels respond to this by using flexible working. Now, this has been difficult to research because most data sources only provide aggregate annual or quarterly summaries of demand and employment. They do not capture the complexities. So we collaborated with a data management company, eProductive, to overcome these obstacles. They provided unique access to detailed hourly and daily records over a five-year period for 80 hotels in three companies. A modeling of labor productivity using these data provided three headline findings. First, outputs per hour worked are three times higher in the most productive hotels than in the least productive ones. Productivity also varies across different departments, say between rooms versus food and beverage. Secondly, up to 12% of the variations in productivity can be accounted for by differences in how hotels managed labor flexibility. So it really is important. Thirdly, what matters is not whether you use flexible labor practices, but how you use these. For example, whether your flexibility comes from moving workers between departments rather than within them, and whether you rely on casual workers or you expect full-time employees to work flexibly. Overall, our research has had three main impacts beyond the university sector. First, on the three hotel chains. We've benchmarked the performances of their individual hotels and departments, identifying those with the greatest potential to improve productivity. And our findings on flexible working have informed a range of HR practices, from recruitment to staff rostering to training. All this has contributed to improving their productivity. The second impact was on eProductive. Our research helped them to redesign their data management system so as to capture the complexities of flexible working. And it also strengthened the consultancy advice they provide to some 40 hotel groups. Finally, Andrew Lockwood, Yuri Kim and I were commissioned to produce a report for Visit Britain on tourism productivity. This was part of their successful initiative to secure a multi-million pound tourism sector deal as part of the government industrial strategy to address the UK productivity gap. In many ways, that deal is a game changer. So where do we go next? Well, inevitably, there are questions about how hotels deal with productivity. During the COVID-19 pandemic, when demand can collapse literally overnight. We've also been examining how Brexit will influence the hospitality labor force and how this in turn will influence productivity. Finally, although we know there is a link between productivity and incomes, we also know it's not mechanical or automatic. So a big question is, who benefits from productivity improvements? And I will leave you with those questions.